Now, I mentioned earlier about the lower astral plane versus the upper. So when you travel out of the body, and by the way, there are MP3 files that Lauren has about my Astral Voyaging CD album and my Time Travelers Training Program album and my Conscious Dying Training Program albums, which will give you these various techniques that you can practice with yourself. Okay, so how do you know you're on the lower astral plane? Remember, you don't want to be there, but you can get out of there if you actually do go there. And there are techniques to do that. My CDs or MP3 files will have that. So here's how you can tell the difference. The lower astral plane, you're going to be in an astral body. So that's not going to be definitive. You know, it can be the upper or lower. But the difference is the environment. You're going to have feelings of confusion and bewilderment if you're on the lower astral. If you're on the upper astral, you're going to have feelings of alertness, peace, and happiness. Unconditional love is a good example. If you're on the lower astral plane, the environment is a misty or foggy environment that looks like you're looking through a cheesecloth. Okay, the upper astral plane has earth-like and beautiful environment. The lower astral plane has the presence of bizarre and evil inhabitants, greys, reptilian ETs, gargoyles, pixies, trolls, all the characters you see from sci-fi movies, you know, vampires, werewolves, fairies, all these entities are negative. And they're associated with the lower astral plane. Remember, you're bullied 24/7 there, so there's no break. On the upper astral plane, you're going to have the presence of human inhabitants. Okay, so you won't have these negative entities there at all. The lower astral plane is noisy and disorganized. The upper astral plane is quiet and well-organized. Lower astral plane, there's absolutely no spiritual growth because there's no contact with your higher self, which we also refer to as the superconscious mind. On the upper astral plane, of course, you have unlimited spiritual growth and you can connect with your higher self, which is the techniques I use in my very famous superconscious mind app. Now, what about the kind of people you meet when you're out of the body? Again, versus the lower, versus the physical plane, versus, let's say, the fifth dimension. If you're on the physical plane when you're doing hypnosis, you haven't quite left the body, you're going to be preoccupied with the earth plane, chores. If you see, for example, physical people while you're out of the body and you're looking at the physical plane, they won't notice you or look upon you or be able to communicate. You're going to be a ghost to them. So they don't have any way of communicating with you. If you're communicating with an astral entity or a fifth dimensional entity, assuming it's the astral plane, they're not going to be preoccupied. They will look at you and speak with you. Of course, all communication is telepathic. You're just going to be like going out with your friends. Again, when you're on the fifth dimension and you look down at physical plane people, they're always affected by gravity. When you're in the fifth dimension and you're speaking with fifth dimensional entities, they're rarely affected by gravity. They can levitate, fly, teleport, do whatever they want to do. The auras of a physical person when you're in the fifth dimension will have an irregular or discolored aura. If you see a astral body when you're on the astral plane, let's say, they will have clear, regularly shaped and evenly colored aura. Okay, and of course, earth plane people wear contemporary clothes, unless of course you're in Los Angeles, that's a whole different ballgame. Whereas astral entities wear out of place clothes because they tend to take the form of their previous life. So they may be hundreds of years out of date in their fashion citation mentality here, okay? So this is the idea of what happens with the different dimensional experiences here. Now, when you go through out-of-body experiences, if you experience paralysis, that is a normal experience. We'll give you techniques like psychic protection to eliminate that. But don't panic if you have that. That's a natural example of the neurological level of entering into an alpha brainwave level when you go to sleep at night. Remember one concept. When you go to sleep at night, you dream for 3 hours a night. This is scientific research. This is hard research back for the last 60 years. The last stage is called the REM cycle, stage 5 of a sleep cycle. And you are not only in a very deep level of alpha, but you're actually in the fifth dimension. So all dreams are out-of-body experiences. So dreams are natural. That's one of the reasons why you know they're not dangerous. You don't remember them, I grant you, but you can be trained to remember them. But you can also have conscious out-of-body experiences, which is what we're going to be training you to do today. Now, before I open this up for some questions, I want to just give a couple of little, what I call, behaviors that you can facilitate your application of these techniques and your own spiritual growth. One of the things you can do to actually help yourself in your daily life on the earth plane is being loving, unselfish, and kind. Love is the most important quality in the universe. Be a giver. Decrease the attachment to material possessions. Enjoy them all you want, but be willing to lose them without envy, resentment, anger, or other negative emotional responses. Remember, it's materialism only. Your soul is what counts. It's permanent, it's eternal, and it is the big picture. Be empowered. I call this psychic empowerment. Be God-oriented instead of world-oriented. Be humble. Remove all tendencies to be superficial, vain, and phony. Learn not to identify too strongly with your body. Protect it, of course, and be healthy and vigilant. I have no problem with that. But say to yourself, I am spiritual, I am a spiritual soul, immortal and eternal. I create my own reality. The body eventually dies, but the soul is eternal.